another episode storyboarded by Tom Price.
And another episode where we get to see the characters waking up.
Yep.
I always wanted to put Russel in this treehouse ship.
Shit.
That was kind of funny.
I love his slippers.
He's got little...
I love the transition he does a little bit later. A little hop. Look for the hop.
See, this is where we decide that he's a shoe fetish.
He's a shoe fetish.
He's a shoe Amelda Marcos type.
Hey, that's it. It's too close to
there
home.
We go.
That's right.
Yar. Yar.
Hey,
it's Lumpy.
We haven't seen him before.
We haven't seen him for almost a minute. Thought something happened to him. Best dolphins.
It's a nice little walk-on roll for Disco.
Oh, that's uncomfortable.
That banana hammock is too much.
But Hawk stares an uncomfortably long period of time at Disco Bear.
I love that shot.
Yeah, the eyes.
Up to no good.
Surprising that Lifty and Shifty walk around Happy Tree Friend Town.
And they let him?
Yeah, they know, you know.
They let Lumpy be their doctor.
That's true.
Touché. There's lots of things wrong in the world of Happy Tree. That Lifty and Shifty walking around is like the least of the problem.
So their innocent fishing expedition now becomes a treasure hunt.
One coin.
Who knows what you're gonna be leaving the house? You're leaving the ship.
We love this gag. I remember it made.
It worked better on paper.
Yeah,
though.
It worked better. It did. I remember when I was like after watching, I was like. It doesn't quite play out.
Yeah. Oh, we thought it was genius.
I think it was drawn on the board.
See, it's a washing machine that he was seeing at the porthole, you guys.
I'm particularly amused by how there is no subtlety whatever to him vomiting there. No turning around or hiding behind his back.
Oh, Disco, he didn't even deserve it.
He was just minding his own business.
They often don't deserve it. I think that's where the humor comes from a lot of the time.
How do they know where they are? I remember this episode totally, it came from the idea we wanted the deep sea diving.
Well, we wanted to do a treasure.
We wanted to do
like
that.
Like Russel go out with on
just,
a ship.
Just this, just him going down.
And we worked on the deep sea diving thing for months and months and months.
Well, that's what we had for a long time.
That's all we had.
We had it finished at one point, and then we lost the notes. We had
every
beat worked
right.
out, and we all were looking everywhere for the notes.
What is that
that book never worked. By the way, skeleton, human.
It's sort of a Planet of the Apes. Oh, we love this gag. Again, another one on paper that I thought...
It's okay.
I think it's funny.
It was way funnier when we were talking about it.
The fact that guys put all this little extra bit in it, too. It's great.
There you
Cheating
go.
Cheating at chess.
So the guys who animate this up at Fat Cat are in this tiny little town called Miramichi. And I think the studio is about half the population of the town.
Another gag that we thought would be great.
I still like this. I think it works fine.
The 18 moment. Here's another expectation reverse.
And then the fish all be fine.
Now what I think is funny is he's scratched under the glass.
Yeah.
And of course Lumpy sleeping on the job.
And standing on the hose.
Yeah, this is a funny gag.
This one I think works pretty good. Lumpy's Jacques Cousteau outfit is kind of nice.
Did you make Lumpy French? And the whole ship.
And we love, it was the eye contact.
That moment.
Yeah.
Like, we're both doomed.
This isn't good.
We should have gone fishing.
Nicely done, too.
And those cute dolphins are back.
The callback.
You can see their tails up there.
And now becomes a slightly different story.
I don't know. It seems like that submarine would be even more valuable in all that gold.
It's a disco
submarine. It's disco. It's a yellow submarine.
You know what? Didn't we talk about it being all discoed out in like 70s on the inside? Oh, we thought the metal worked better with the. What's about to come next?
I love their pockets.
Yeah. Raccoon pockets.
They're marsupials. Kind of.
The underwater sea life is really nice.
That's the first time I've seen it with the heat effects. That really helped to sell the gags.
Yeah, it's cool. This is always a funny bit when one brother has to always betray the other.
It's always tempting for people to believe that there's some kind of karma about why these guys end up dying because they're greedy, but it just doesn't extend to the rest of the characters. Yeah. I mean, they don't really die for any reason besides the fact that some fans seem to find it amusing. I have to figure out why.
That would probably hurt a lot.
Yeah. Molten metal.
Down the mouth.
Molten gold. And volcanoes, always good times.
Gold!
And again, here's that moment
life
I could go
gold.
Up and save myself, but no, I must get the gold!
I remember this extended out really long. Didn't we have him like they actually had made it to the surface or something and he had him? Remember there was like, he just saved him.
He just won't let go. There's Lumpy.
Yeah. Here's where it gets all the
Twilight. Cuddles is okay in this episode.
It's fine. But who's drawing all those maps? Actually, that was one of the original endings we had, was we were going to reveal that it was Lumpy.
On the island.
On the island, drawing maps just to get rescued or something like that.